back in 2008, basically I was tired of all the men's magazines that were put out there. They didn't speak to me as a man. I was tired of like articles about how to get 8-pack abs, articles featuring men without any body hair or facial hair for that matter, and you know, articles on how to wear $5,000 suits. So I decided to start my own kind of men's interest site, the kind of magazine that I would want to read. And so here we are 4 years later, 100,000 subscribers. We have content about everything, about grooming and style, fitness and health, money, career, family, and relationships. And the kind of the vibe I go for is, it's definitely a very masculine thing we got going here. I get a lot of inspiration from my grandfather, my dad, sort of the old school manliness where, you know, it's, you know, facial hair, body hair, just sort of a classic Renaissance man thing that, you know, like my grandfather kind of embodied. So that's what you'll find on the site. And I think mustached Americans will definitely like what we're doing here. In fact, our kind of unofficial mascot on the site is John L. Sullivan, the famous bare-knuckled fisticuffer. And he rocked a really fantastic handlebar mustache. It's very iconic. So I think mustache Americans definitely love the site.
And of course, you're sporting a pretty dapper lip sweater. And you were telling me that you are a person of mustache American heritage. Your father himself was a mustache bearer.
Yeah, my entire life growing up, I only saw my dad without a mustache maybe once or twice. And when he did it, I honestly felt like a stranger walked into my home, and he quickly grew the mustache back. So yeah, a few years ago, I decided to follow that heritage and I grew a mustache of my own.
And of course, you know, you're based in Tulsa, Oklahoma. In the state of Oklahoma, I believe it's standard operating procedure to own and or operate a mustache, is it not?
You see the mustache quite a bit. We're out here in cowboy country, so you see quite a few mustaches, which is nice because I don't feel like an odd duck out here. I have a lot of solidarity out here in Oklahoma with my mustache brothers.
I know that Oklahoma City was actually in the top 10 for we released the America's Most Mustache Friendly City, and Oklahoma City was in the top 10. I know Tulsa, I believe, was in the top 50 as well, so I know there's a rich heritage there in the state.
There is.
So it is, you know, we're getting to the holiday season, and I would imagine you take a lot of time to look at some of the more manly gifts that are out there. So we'd love to get your perspective, perfect time of the year, on some of the more manly items.
Yeah, so there's a lot of holiday gift guides out there for men, and honestly, I think most of them are just junk. It's really dumb stuff like bacon-flavored toothpaste or just really useless stuff. And a lot of it's also a lot of electronic digital stuff, which is fine. But what I like to see underneath the Christmas tree for me personally are more kind of timeless, classic, manly stuff, like kind of stuff that my grandpa would own. So this year, there's a few things that I liked personally. One of them is one thing I really recommend that I think any man would love underneath the Christmas tree is a product from Saddleback Leather Company. This is a company based out of San Antonio, Texas, and it's designed these just wonderful leather bags. They have a 100-year lifetime, 100-year guarantee on it, and they claim that your grandkids will fight over it when you're dead. I own one of these bags. They're awesome. I mean, they're hard to really describe, you know, but you have to go see it. So you go to saddlebackleathercompany.com to see their selection. Just a really useful, timeless, classic gift. Another gift that I'm really fond of, Pendleton Woolen Mills, the iconic woolen mills factory that's been producing shirts and sweaters for almost a century. They've just released these awesome robes, like lounge robes. I think every man needs a robe they can, you know, cozy up in on a cold day while they're drinking their morning coffee, reading the paper. These are made out of 100% virgin wool, and it's the type of thing that you're going to pass down to your kids and your grandkids, and you're just going to look fantastic. You're going to feel fantastic in it. So another gift that I'm really excited about, and I think a lot of men would love this gift, it's called McKinley's Rare Old Highland Malt Whiskey. What it is, it's a replica whiskey of the whiskey that Ernest Shackleton, the Arctic explorer, took with him when he explored the Antarctic. And a few years ago, some people who were restoring his hut down there in the Antarctic stumbled upon a case of this whiskey. It was frozen, and it was called McKinley's Old Highland Malt Whiskey. So this company has taken this whiskey and recreated it. So if you want to harness your inner adventurer, your inner explorer, this is definitely a gift that you should put on your list. And again, it's a limited supply. I think there's only like, they only made 57,000 bottles of it. So you'll have to act fast if you want that. Another gift that I'm kind of, this is for the mustache crowd out there, is actor Nick Offerman. He's the gentleman that plays Ron Swanson on Parks and Recreation. One of my favorite shows, one of my favorite characters on television, who's also mustache. He's actually a woodworker. He does that sort of his second career, and he owns a wood shop. And he's designed these awesome hand-carved mustache combs. And he's hand-carved them. They're made of different exotic woods, local woods in California. And they're just a nice mustache comb. So I think it's kind of neat if you know somebody who's a fan of Ron Swanson and also has a mustache. This would be a great gift. Another gift that I'm definitely fond of this year is, I'm hoping that I get, is a nice hand-carved shaving brush. I shave the old way. Sometimes I switch between a safety razor and a straight razor, but I always lather up with a brush. A lot of companies out there, just small craftsmen who make their own badger brushes, and they hand turn them. They just look really nice. So I'm hoping to get one of those. And if you're looking for something a little more on the, I guess, sort of kind of lower, more affordable, lower budget gift ideas or stocking stuffer, even a pot, you can never go wrong with a pocket knife. Every man should carry a pocket knife. You never know when you'll need it. They always come in handy. And one knife that I'm looking at this year and we're recommending on our gift guide is the Oppenheimer knife. This is a knife that was designed in the 1890s by this Frenchman with a wooden handle. And it just looks really cool. I mean, it looks like something that your grandpa would carry.
No, I'm hoping that I can get some of that whiskey. And of course, I always wear a robe to church that's made out of mustache fibers from a North American dwarf. So I'm very excited about the robe as well, personally. But sounds like some great offerings there. Well, Brett, thank you very much for joining the American Mustache Institute. This has been a long time coming, and we look forward to visiting you at the Art of Manliness.
It's been a pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Thank you.